Hello. I haven't done a video in quite a little while, and I've had a few requests as to how to center clay. And the first thing you want to do when you cut a block of clay off is just round it out and form it into a ball. And this just kind of helps the starting process when you put it on the wheel. The other thing is, too, you want to make sure that your bat's clean so the ball won't go sliding off the bat. You can also pad the ball into place when it's on the bat just a little. Now, two things that might help when you're throwing is resting your arms on your legs and using your legs as kind of leverage to keep your arms in place, or putting your elbows inside your legs. Another way is to put your forearms on the splash guard here and kind of rest them on the splash guard. Now, when you're centering, you want to also make sure that you use quite a bit of water, so then that way the clay's not sticking to your hands too much. When I center, I put my hands together like this, and you don't have to press them together. You can have them about an inch apart, but I put my hands together, and the inside of my palms right here is the area that's going to push the clay. And I'm going to literally push the clay straight forward away from me, and that'll put it into place. Now, it's centered on the sides, but on the top it's still a little rough. So there's two different ways of roughing off or smoothing off the top. You can put your hand on the top and put one hand on the side. Push down on the top and then guide the clay on the side. Or you can put two hands on top and push down on the clay. The majority of the pressure that I'm putting on the clay is coming from the palms of my hands and not really my fingers. My fingers are a guide. So just as a reminder, when you center, put your hands together like this. The palms of your hands should be what's forcing the clay in place. Your fingers on the outside are just a guide for the clay. Now, you can also knead the clay while you're on the wheel, and this gets rid of air bubbles. Instead of having to knead it on a kneading on a table, you can knead it on the potter's wheel. Kneading it is pulling the clay up and then pushing it back down, and it creates kind of a circular motion, and it gets rid of all the air bubbles in the clay. And pulling it up is literally just squeezing the clay, and then when you push it back down, you can use the tops of your hands and push it back down again. And when you're pushing it back down, you want to push it back down, but leave a little bit of clay in the center that comes back up again. And that clay, you can start hearing air bubbles burst when you're doing this. It also gets rid of any hard spots in the clay. And you'll notice when you start throwing a bowl and a wall will start wobbling a little, and you'll notice that. That's because there may be a little bit of a hard spot in the clay. This will help get rid of some of that. And that is how you center clay. So I hope this video helps.